everyone. I hope you had a great Memorial Day weekend. In honor of Memorial Day this week, we're going to create some more pixel art, but we're going to do an American theme. So what we're going to create here is an American flag, and I'm going to show you how to go about going and creating it yourself. So I'm going to go ahead and delete all that so you can kind of get an idea of what we're making. So to build off of what we did last time, remember you're going to be using these two columns, A and B, up here. A tells you what number you press into your Google Sheet here, and B will tell you what color that number corresponds to. So for example, again, if I type 1 here and push enter or push my over arrow keys, it will become that color. So what we're going to start with today is we're going to start with the American flag. So what we're going to do is we're going to start all the way up here at D1, and we're going to make that blue. And if I look at my color column, blue in B is 7. So if I want to do that nice deep blue, I do 7 and my over arrow. And I can kind of keep my two fingers on those two keys. So I can have 7 and my over key. And I'm going to go all the way over to L1. Once I'm at L1, I can go down, and I'm going to go down all the way until D7. So I can look to the left here, and I can see that 7's right there. And that will be my last one I'm going to fill in. And then I'm going to go over and meet it. Just like that. Once I do that, I can fill in the rest and go down all the way L to L7. And I can fill in the rest of this rectangle here. So I'm going to type in 7 all the way through, which is pretty easy. If I miss one, it's okay. I can go back. If you make a mistake, let's say you hit the wrong one and I hit maybe a light blue or I hit a red and I made some accidents there, I can always press Control Z or however many times I made the mistake, and it will go back to the original form. So I can do that all the way until the original if I wanted to. So I'm going to keep typing 7s in here until this is a completely blue rectangle. Okay, once I'm done, I'm going to start creating the stripes on the American flag. So I'm going to look over here, and the very first color the flag starts with up top is the color red. So I'm going to take my number 1, and I'm going to start at the very tippy top where it starts M1. And I'm going to type in 1, and I'm going to go all the way over until Z, which is kind of easier. Once you hit Z, you can stop. And if you go down, you know the next color on the American flag is white, so you're not going to fill this row in at all. So you're gonna leave row 2 blank, so this whole entire row, and go down 1. So you're skipping one each time you go. It's sort of like a color pattern. You have red, white, and I'm going to do it all over again in row 3 here. I'm gonna skip row 4. I'm going to right to row 5, so it's all the odd numbers so far that we're filling in. So it's 1, 3, 5. If you know what the next odd number is here, we have 7. So again, we're at M7 now, and we're filling in M7 all the way over until Z7. Okay. Once I go down here, obviously we're not going to do the next row, which is row 8 here, where you see the little box highlighted. But we do have to come down 1, and we're not going to start at M this time. We're going to start all the way over at D. So we're going to type in the number 1 for the red, and we're going to fill it all the way over. Keep pressing that arrow key each time you type in number 1 until you get all the way to Z, which I have. Skip a row. So again, you're starting at the next row, which is going to be 11. And you can kind of see that American flag coming out now that we've gotten the bottom red rows all the way across. All right, and once you do that one, we're actually going to go down to row 13 here and do one more row of that. And now that is completed. Well, I really like it as the way it is. We know the American flag has stars on. So what I want to do here is I want to help you add stars. But first I want you to take note of the color that the stars are. The color that I set for white is 12. So we're going to go right into E2, so we're not along the border of our flag, and we're just going to type the number 12 into it. And when we do that, we're going to move it over, and it will create it white. So we're going to skip the next one, and we're going to go one over. So we're going to start at E2, we're skipping F2, we're going straight to G2. So we're doing every other one right now. So if we've just done G, we're moving over to I2, typing in 12. And then the last one will be K2 here. So I'm going to type a 12, and I'm going to go push my arrow down. And so we have 4 to start. What I want to do is I want to try to stagger them. Remember, we're not creating circles or star shapes technically on here because they are all boxes. So what we're going to do is we're going to stagger the stars a little bit. And by stars, I mean these squares that are here. So we're going to drop down to F this time. So we're starting at F3, and I'm typing in 12. I'm going to move my arrow key over. I'm going to skip one box. I'm going to skip G. I'm going to H this time. So H3 and then J3. And then that's all I'm doing in that row. I'm going to go down and I'm going to copy exactly what I did in row 2. And I'm doing exactly what I did in row 2 in row 4. So I'm starting with E4. I'm going to go to G4. I'm going to I4. And I'm going to K4. I'm going to scroll down my arrow key after I press 12. I'm in row 5. I'm going to copy exactly what I did in row 3. So I'm looking up above. And I'm going to do that same thing down here. So I'm going to F5. I'm skipping one. I'm going to H5. I'm doing another one at J5. And then I'm going to do one more row. And I'm copying again my very first row, which is starting with letter E. So I'm going, instead of E2, I'm going down to E6. So I'm going to press 12 over, skip one, 12 over, skip one, 12 over, and then finally my last star, I'm going to type 12 in box K, 6, and over. And that completes the American flag. So when you are all finished yours, make sure that you press turn in up at the top on Google Classroom, and you will be complete your pixel art for the week. Have fun!